ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا called a street after you have guided it. We should make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to also give us that steadfastness and consistency. It was easy in the month of Ramadan because everybody was doing it. There was this mahul, there was this environment, there was this atmosphere, there was this spirituality, there was this enthusiasm. It was easy to do it. But once the Ramadan went away, we came back to what we were before Ramadan. The capability Allah has given us, the istita'at which showed us in the month of Ramadan, that is not being shown outside the month of Ramadan. We are like the tree, Sidi Sidi Rahmatullah, one of the great pious persons. He's walking on the street and a tree speaks to him. He gets this ilham, inspiration from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some very pious people get this inspiration from Allah. The tree speaks to him, Yasirikum Misli. O tree, become like me. So he said, Rahmatullah, says, why should I become like you? What is so good about you? The tree says, الَّذِينَ يَرْمُونَ الْأَحْجَارِ قُلْعِهِمْ بِالْأَسْمَارِ. When people throw rocks at me, I give them fruits. So become like me. People say bad things to you, people do bad to you, do good to them. People break ties with you, join with them. People oppress you, do injustice to you, forgive them. In other words, have this good akhlaq, tolerance, forbearance, forgiveness, giving nature like me. Sidi Sidi Rahmatullah says, if you're so good, why do people cut you off? They slice you off and they burn you and use your wood. Why do they do that? Then the tree says, as many good qualities I have, there is one weakness in me which overshadows all the good qualities I have. And what is that? Sidi Sidi Rahmatullah asks. And the tree says, whenever the wind blows, I blow in that direction. I'm not firm and strong and steadfast. I just blow in the direction of the wind. Allah forgive, our nature is like that too because of our weakness. If my heart says I should recite Quran, I recite. If my heart doesn't say, I don't. If I feel like going to the masjid, I go, otherwise I do not. If I feel like I wake up for Fajr, otherwise I do not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us the rewards for doing good deeds. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. Allah knows every action of good you do. Allah knows that. And Allah knows every small action of bad, Adam's way of bad you do, Allah knows that. And Allah will reward us for all the good actions. But the nur, the light of those actions, good actions, that is supposed to enter our hearts, the nur of Allah, the nur of those actions is missing from our lives because we are not consistent and regular. No matter what the conditions and situations I'm going through, I'm still firm and steadfast, then Allah will make us feel the nur in our hearts. The consistency brought the coolness and comfort to the eyes of Prophet ﷺ. Consistency of salat brought coolness in his eyes. And that same salat is not bringing coolness to our eyes because I'm missing the nur. Istiqamah, that steadfastness and consistency, to have that motivation and drive, to get up and do wudu even if I'm tired and exhausted, to recite Quran, to do dhikr. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever recites Surah Al-Waqi'ah every night, again, the words are every night, regularly, consistently. Rasulullah said, whoever recites Surah Al-Waqi'ah, this is the 27th juz of the Quran, whoever recites Surah Al-Waqi'ah every night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never afflict that person with poverty. With hard, bad financial times, Allah will never afflict that person. Said Abdullah ibn Masud radiallahu anhu was dying. He was on his deathbed. The Khalifa of the time, Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu, visits him. and he sees his one-bedroom apartment, just like the house of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nothing in his apartment except very basic elementary needs of life. Nothing else. Three young daughters. Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu says, "Oh Abdullah, you're not leaving anything for your daughters, young daughters." He says, "Oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, leader of the believers, haven't you heard the saying of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that whoever recites Surah Al-Baqarah every night, Allah will never afflict that person with poverty. I have taught my daughter Surah Al-Baqarah to recite every night." What yaqeen, what conviction, faith in the words of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They would believe in the words of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than they would see things in front of their eyes. I have taught my daughter Surah Al-Baqarah, and he died. Just in a short span of time, three princes of the time got married to those three brothers. The effect of the blessings of Surah Al-Baqarah. Allahumma barik fi al-maut wa fi ma ba'd al-maut. Oh Allah, bless me in death and bless me in what comes after death. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever says these words, if you don't know the Arabic words, you can say in our own language. Allahumma barik fi al-maut wa fi ma ba'd al-maut. Oh Allah, bless me in death and bless me in what comes after death. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever recites these words or says these words, Allah will make him or her die, even though they die in a natural way, Allah will make them rise as a shaheed, as a martyr on the day of judgment. Because when a person remembers death, it brings him to the reality of the life of the hereafter. It reminds him to prepare for the everlasting life of the hereafter. It brings him the reality of this short, temporary, deceptive world. And makes the trials and tribulations of this life easier for him to face. Because he knows his impending death is coming. He's going to finish and end everything in this life. Luqman alayhi salam is advised his son, "Oh my son, as you go to sleep in the night, so death will come to you. If you don't have that firm yaqeen, conviction that death will come to you, then don't go to sleep in the night. As you wake up in the morning, oh my son, similarly you will rise one day from your grave on the day of judgment, day of resurrection. And if you do not believe in the day of resurrection, don't wake up in the morning. Because death, sleep, is the sister of death," said Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahumma bi ismika amutu wa ahya. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said dua before we go to sleep. Oh Allah, say these words, said Rasulullah. Oh Allah, in your name I die, and in your name I live. And when you wake up, alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dana amatana wa ilayhi nushur. All praises be to him who has given me life after death, and to him we're returning back. When you say this day in and day out, night in and night out, it reminds you, listen, today I woke up, tomorrow I may not wake up. Tonight I'm going to sleep, tomorrow I may not go to sleep in the grave. This reminds of this consistency, this istiqamah, this regularity reminds a person of death, of the life, of the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us understanding. أَقُلْ يُقَلِيَادَ أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ Please make dua that I get for the midnight or the early hours of the morning prayers. Hasan Basri rahmatullah tells him, you correct your actions of the daytime, Allah will make you up for tahajjud. You correct your actions of the daytime, Allah will correct, Allah will make you up for tahajjud. And the man says, I'm not able to do all the good actions I used to do. What can I do? How can I motivate myself? Hassan Basri rahmatullahi says, leave sins, and Allah will make you do good actions. Hazrat Fatima radiallahu anha and Hazrat Ali radiallahu anha, they were going through very bad times, hard times. Allah will never test us like that. One time he said to Fatima radiallahu anha, why don't you go ask Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he has some captives of war. Ask some help from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we need some help. She comes to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She's shy to ask for help. The respect and the reverence and the awe she had of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then she says, oh Prophet of Allah, I was thinking of asking you for some help with the prisoners of war that have come. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, oh my daughter, I'm so sorry, I cannot give you any help because there are more poor people than you who need more help. Ashab Sufa. She returns back. That night there is a knock on the door of Fatima radhiyallahu anha's house. She opens up the door and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is standing. And he sees the face of Fatima radhiyallahu anha now in more detail. Her eyes have sunk, her cheeks have gone inside, her face has turned pale. Tears roll down the eyes of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looking at her. She says, oh my daughter, what has happened to you? What is going on? She says, Ya Rasulullah, amradun asqan awja. Sickness, O Prophet of Allah. Blisters on my hand, crying in the car. Starvation, hunger, O Prophet of Allah. Can't even feed my infant sons. Chest in the pains of Ali for pulling the water from the well to earn the livelihood from the house. Immediately, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam takes attention from the sufferings of this world, from the trials and tribulations and tests of this world, to the vastness of the life of the hereafter. He says, oh my daughter, shall I teach you something which really has taught me? Please do, O Prophet of Allah. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, after every salat, say subhanallah 10 times, alhamdulillah 10 times, and Allahu Akbar 10 times. And before you go to sleep, say subhanallah 33 times, alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 34 times. Fatima radiallahu anha would say later on, see, it's very easy for me to say this, the same mashallah, a very comfortable, grand masjid, beautiful carpets, air conditioning, comfortable environment, atmosphere, alhamdulillah. But they have to pay a heavy price to get these words of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So she would say later, I never forgot to say those words after every salat before I went to sleep. I would wake up in the morning after saying those words in the night. I would wake up with so much full of strength, vigor, and energy. Ali radiallahu would say the same thing to the people way after Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, when he was the Khalifa Amir al-Mu'mineen. One man asked, did you say those words even in the battle of Jabal, in the battle of Siffin, when you were extremely busy that night in the battle and the skirmishes going on? He said, even that night, I took 10 out to say subhanAllah, alhamdulillah, Allah over 33, 33, 34 times. What is the honor? What steadfastness? What consistency? Small action, but the istiqamah was like mountains. Huge. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, last moments of his life, he's lying on the chest of Hazrat Aisha radiallahu anha. The brother of Hazrat Aisha radiallahu anha, Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Bakr, standing right there. And Rasulullah, with the very desiring eyes, looks at the miswak in the pocket of Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Bakr. New miswak, uncut. Rasulullah looks at the ayun, at the miswak, the toothstick. Hazrat Aisha realizes that Rasulullah wants to brush his teeth before he departs the world to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She takes a miswak from the pocket of her brother, chews it, puts it around the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, brushes his teeth. And then a few moments after the Rasulullah said, Allahumma rafiq al-a'la, take me the company of the exalted ones. Consistency, steadfast. Rasulullah would do miswak 5 times for every salah before wudu. In the night time before you go to sleep. In the morning when you wake up. You use it when you come home from outside. Consistent and regular. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, many virtues of using this toothpaste. And we can use this after before every salah. We can use our toothpaste, alhamdulillah, no problems. But along with that, use the miswak before every salah for second business. Many virtues Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. One of the great virtues of that using miswak, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you remember the kalima before death. Allah will make the kalima the last words on your tongue before you die. And whoever recites the kalima before death, Rasulullah says, dakhala al-jannah, he or she will enter paradise. Small action, but the rewards. At that time, at the time of death, shaitan will come with his full force to his guidance. He did not leave a person like Muhammad in alhamdulillah. How can he leave us? But these small actions, miswak, reciting Quran every day, praying 5 times salat every day, on a regular, consistent basis, not only the spiritual actions, but istiqamah, steadfastness, firmness, consistency in our akhlaq. Speaking the truth always, not when I'm being a huge prophet, I can lie, or I can lie for my meetings coming late in the meeting. It's truthful all the time. Consistent in our akhlaq all the time. Not only that, including our tawbah, our repentance, consistency. What is consistency in our repentance and tawbah? That I should not rest in peace until I seek forgiveness for that sin I committed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It should not make me go to sleep in the night till I seek repentance from Allah. Ya qalbi al-qulub, thabbit qalbi ala deen. The most dua recited by Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his wife Umm Salama radiallahu anha would say, O the controller of the hearts, make my heart firm on your deen, on your religion, O Allah. May Allah make us among those. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروني